What's up, guys? So today's video is just a quick one to talk about something that I have been wanting for a little while, but it was just not possible without official information. That is, what's gonna happen with a cutoff point this year, okay, 2025. And as you guys might know, on the 7th of August, if I'm not mistaken, we had some official announcement being made, which gave us a little bit of more ground to talk about these topics. But first of all, let's just remind ourselves what happened with the cutoff points in 2024. So 2024 was an easier exam, and basically what happened is that with Cambridge no longer crafting the test, that responsibility was transferred to the Italian ministry, which made things a little bit more unusual than we were used to. So the questions were concentrated a lot easier and more simple, and we could see that pattern in different sections, biology, chemistry, and basically that led us to an inflated score. So my initial thoughts about this was that candidates would probably realize that mastering biology and chemistry would not be enough. So we would probably see a wave of people preparing through mathematics, physics, and logical reasons, which would make like an overall cutoff point a bit higher. So yeah, if nothing had been changed, that was my expectation. Higher cutoff point for mastering mathematics, physics, and things getting a little bit more complicated. But to be honest, in order to make a reasonable prediction, two information was lacking, okay? First of all, will they hire a professional writer like Cambridge or something like this? Because if they do, that could probably balance the exam and stabilize the cutoff point. But if they don't, it's still gonna be the Italian ministry. So yeah, cutoff point high, people crying all the time, that's it. Secondly, what about the syllabus? Is it going to be the same as the previous year, or are they going to change something? Okay, are they going to officially remove anatomy and physics that I have been seeing for the past 3 years? Okay, so let's deal with the elephant in the room. We already have an answer for these questions, so let's not waste time and pretend we don't. Okay, so the big question here is, who's going to prepare the IMAT this year? Is it going to be the Italian ministry once again, which prepares so well the previous exam? Spoiler alert, no. I know, shocking, but according to the new ministerial decree, the 2025 exam will be handled by Cineca. Now, if you've never heard about Cineca, don't worry, you're not alone. I didn't either, but it kind of sounds like one of those Marvel villains. In reality, it's basically a inter-university consortium, whatever that is. So no, unfortunately, it's not Cambridge again, but don't worry. It's also not going to be just some random office worker in Rome scribbling some questions on their lunch break. So in theory, this guy should know what they're doing. They're known for handling large-scale testing and admission systems for a living. So unlike the past adventures of the IMAT, this year we should expect a test that really looks like it was designed for the purpose. And the idea is to keep the same system for the following years as well, so we can finally have a more standardized and consistent IMAT exam. Now, talking about the syllabus, a moment of tension here. Actually not. Nothing changed. The syllabus remained the same, so unfortunately you can't ditch anatomy and physiology from your preparation. Yeah, I know, tragic, but if you thought you could ignore these two topics from your preparation, the syllabus say, think again. Okay, so what does this all mean for the cutoff point in the IMAT 2025? Well, with Cineca now writing the questions, and based on everything we know, the difficulty of the test might get a little bit higher. In other words, don't expect to be showered easy questions. Those thank you for the 1 point questions might show up less often. And since the syllabus remained the same, this gave them opportunity to explore areas that haven't been explored for a little while, like anatomy and physiology. Alright, so based on everything we talked and all the new information that we have available, my overall review is that we're probably going to be seeing some cutoff point a bit lower this year compared to 2024 IMAT, but a special attention for the University of Bologna for the Europeans since there's more seats available, and for the non-Europeans, the University of Naples might be a good shot, and also the University of Vergata since it's a newer location, new university, so this is probably going to drop the cutoff point even more. Alright guys, so I hope this video was helpful in any way, and if it was, don't forget to leave it a like and subscribe to the channel. Oh, and if you have your own prediction for the cutoff points, put in the comments. Who knows? Maybe one of you guys will guess it right and will become the next IMAT Nostradamus. So right, that's it for the day. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys in the next one.